All right, now I have a 2012 Chevy Cruze. I'm gonna shoot this one out in the sun. I got it set up so I can still see the sticker. The sticker is on the opposite side where the sun isn't glaring. This is a manual, 6-speed, it's cloth interior, no sunroof. Still get the alloy wheels. But I'm telling you, that's peppy motor. I'm really surprised. 6-speed manual transmission. The gas mileage is better than the automatic, which is unusual. The 6-speed automatics usually get better gas mileage than the 6-speed manuals. But this thing has done a really nice job on this motor. For the gas mileage you get a lot of power. Chevy figured something out. Now, I don't know where they're getting the motors from. Some of you people out there that are a lot more techy at that stuff than I am. You can see it is the Cruze. Seems a little quieter in the 12, a little tighter. It's like the 11 seemed to have more rattles and more road noise. This 12 seemed to have less, at least it seemed to me, and I drove it right after, so one thing I didn't care about, the 11 seemed awful, like a lot of stuff was making noise, and this seemed much better. Alright, so let's get a look at the motor in the 12. Actually, I guess we'll do the sticker. LT again. Okay, so it's a 2001 LT. Still has a 1.4 dual overhead cam. And so it does have turbo. Look at that. 4-cylinder turbo. That's how they get away with so much power. Alright, and here's your MSRP. Looks like, yeah, the standard price is $18,475. Gotta figure out how these work. Get your body kit, instrument cluster. It's an RS package. It does say RS on it. Black granite metallic, which is kind of a neat paint. And over here you got, it's total options, and you get your destination charge, so you're right at $20,115. There's probably no rebate programs yet on the 12s like there probably is on the 11s. Here's a little RS decal. Alright, let's take another. Oh yeah, I wanted to show you the paint. I don't know if you can pick it up, but it looks like you can a little bit there. It's got a real black granite look to it. The metallic almost looks like black granite. Alright. So now, we'll open the trunk and the hood. So what I'm going to do is so I can do this at the same time this time. I got to have it out. Wow, you got to actually have the key out of the ignition for that thing to lift. Oh, it's a manual, so now I got to put my shifter back in. One suggestion I'd give Chevy right off the bat is the hood rod to secure the hood lays right over the exhaust. Both of these have been hot to grab. So obviously that's your oil fill, washer fluids. That's your radiator. I don't know what that is. That's either brake or steering. I can never figure it out. and they don't use much English on there anymore. Okay, now let's go do the trunk. Yeah, it looks like same amount of space as the other one had. They go down easy. And the seat belts don't seem to be a problem trying to drop them either. Oh yeah, and I don't think I did the gas mileage on it. You can see 26 and 38, average of 30. Of course, I think the salesman said 35, but we all do that. So, quite a bit of space. I'll leave that seat down. So this is my YouTube walk, then we'll do the inside again. That's interesting. Oh, I didn't restart the fog lights. So you have to re-push the fog lights when the car shuts off. Interesting. Oh yeah, and you get a little rear deck lid spoiler, I noticed on the... Now that might just be part of that RS package, but I didn't see that on the 11. Alright, this one has manual seats. You still get power windows, still get power mirrors. And you did get power locks right here, where the power locks are. Alright, and again we got the push to talk, volume control for the radio. Again, I can't play the radio or... they won't put my video up. Anyways, so here's your cruise. And directionals. And wipers. Let's see how they work. Ah, come on. Alright. And you do get the key that has all the power buttons on it, and it's the flip-out type. You push the button, the key pops out. Alright, there's your information gauge there. And there's your gauges overall. So we did a better job on this camera. It looks a little better this time. There's your lights. It's a dimmer. This is how you do the fog lights that I did the second time. And now hopefully they're on. Alright, and over here there's your AC button, circulation, climate control, hazards, as I said, door lock. Here's all your radio controls, which you have. I'm looking to see if it says satellite. No, I don't see where it says satellite. Oh, it's like also a phone control here besides up here. Let's test it and see. Alright, toners, back clock info. Nope, so I don't see anything that says satellite. Auxiliary doesn't mean satellite, so I guess no satellite radio. Alright, you got cup holders. Power outlet here, little area pocket here, little storage pocket. I don't remember if that was in the other one. Little storage pocket here. Storage pocket over here. I don't know how well you can see that, but there's one right here. Glove box. I guess you got storage in the door. Each door has that, the one on the other side as well. And then here, oh. That must have been up on the last one because I didn't see that auxiliary USB. But again, no power in this section. So if you're plugged in, you still got to run the power out here. I think they would put a power outlet in there. So that's my other suggestion. Power outlet in here with everything else. All right, still we have visors with mirrors, but no lights. Obviously that was the control. We have lights here. Those are definitely easy to tell on and off though. I like that about that feature. All right, this is obviously your information center. This is where you run all your stuff. Interesting. All right. AC seems to work fine. Oh, what's this? Oh, cool, check it out, in a little storage area. I don't know if that was in the last one. If it was, I missed it. All right, here's a view to the back. You can see this. I left the seat down on that one. This is black cloth, like the sport type interior. Very nice, very comfortable. So, oh, it has the auto dim mirror too.
OnStar ready.
Get out. Cool. That does OnStar.
Call, please say the name or number to call.
Cancel.
Cancel. Returning to the main menu. OnStar ready.
Cancel.
Cancel. Thank you. Goodbye.
Cool. That all came on a button on the mirror. I'll show you here without the mirrors. You can't see anything, it's just reflecting off. Anyways, there's three buttons on the bottom here. OnStar is one of them. Alright, so that's going to wrap up the test on the 2012. Let them have them call me, the salesman call me when they get one in leather and a sunroof, because I'd like to check one out. I like the view from the front, but I think this view is better. Got a nice shape, pick up the alloys. So, that's it for today. I'm gonna try to get to a Volkswagen and maybe a Dodge next.